Hi guys, my name is David. Today I'm going to show you how to use the incredible Domino from Festool on panels. First thing first, I'm going to show you three different setups with this plywood. First, we're going to assemble the Domino butt joint with the side of the panel. Second, we are going to assemble this piece in the middle of the panel. So I'm going to show you a trick to align it with any kind of line of your like wants to go with. And third, I'm going to show you a 45 degree angle assembly with the Domino so we can have this well-aligned and solid wood joint on this panel. So this is the Domino from Festool. So we're going to start by tracing the emplacement of the Domino. We're going to put four on each panel. You need to decide how much you want to put. You can put three, you can put two, but the more you put, you have like a good structural glue. It's also easier to align your piece. I will say like one every 12 to 16 inches. It's pretty good. So for this one, I'll use my tape. I'm gonna put one Domino at 8 inches on each side. In my opinion, the less you use your pen, the faster you work. So I'm gonna show you here, there's two little plastic stopper here, and it's really nice because you can use this to align the mortise of the Domino. So this allows you to lock it into position, really stable, and that allows to make the mortise at the exact same placement on all the pieces that you decide to use it, so you work faster. Second trick. To have like a butt joint alignment, you will need to choose the side of the piece you want to go align with the side of the panel. We're gonna use the base of the Domino for the alignment. So we want this side here, we want this side here. So the side we want to go align with the side of the panel needs to go against the table. So you can use your piece here to reproduce the emplacement of the mortise. So I'm gonna use a scrap piece of wood, just a little bit thicker of the panel I'm using. This will allow me to push the tool, the Domino, against the side of my scrap wood. So this way, I know I'm gonna be perfectly flush with the side of the panel, so my mortise will be very precise. For these Domino on this side of the panel, they're gonna go here, 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 and here. When we're gonna put the machine flat on the surface, we're not gonna be able to see the line we put. So a little trick is to reproduce the emplacement of the Domino on the scrap piece of wood. So this way, when I put the machine back, I'll be able to use the center line here to align it with my little line on my scrap piece of wood. So I'll make sure I'll be at the same exact spot. Okay, we have our two piece here. I'm gonna put my safety glasses. Let's proceed with the machining. Domino here. Can I insert it? So you can see the width of the mortise. You have a little space on both sides, so adjustment. And we can see it's pretty tight, so that's good. This is what we want. it's perfectly flush all the way. This is what we want. For our second setup, we want to put this piece somewhere in the center of the panel. So I'm going to show you how I do it. Let's say we want to install the piece at 12 3/4 from the side here. So 12 3/4. Same thing on the other side, 12 3/4. This piece is flat, so we can use it to draw a sharp line. And as the other piece, we would like to have a domino at 8 inches from both sides. We're going to use the stopper on the machine to make this one on both sides here. My little trick, I always like to draw where the domino is going to be. So we want it on the side of the line. So by drawing it, you have a visual of on where you want to put the domino. So if you have many pieces at the same time that you're machining, if you turn it, you always see which side of the line you need to put the machine. And on this one, I'm going to use my piece and I'm going to clamp it against the panel. And I took a really good care to position the piece I'm going to use for aligning straight on the line that I draw on my panel. So same thing here. I need to put my line at 8 inches on both sides, because where I'm going to put the machine on the panel, I'm not going to be able to see the line. So I'm going to use the center line under the panel, under the base, the machine, to align it directly on my line here with the base of the machine really well push against the piece we have here. So my domino are good to go on my panel. Now I need to machine domino on the side of this piece. So the difference between the two setup is the side of the machine. So on this one, the machine was flush against the side of the panel at the bottom. But here, the machine is on the other side. So that means the line we trace are on the opposite side of the piece. It doesn't matter for this because we can flip it. But what I'm saying, if you choose, let's say like you have like a nice grain of wood on one side and you wanted to see it on a specific side, you need to be aware of that. So now we have both dominoes machine, and we can put our piece into position. And as we can see here, the bottom part here is perfectly aligned with the line we draw at the beginning. So that was the goal. All right, for our last setup here, the 45 degree angle. On the first two here, we use the base to align the mortise. On this one, we're going to use the platter. So 45 degrees angle. I'm going to loose both adjustment here. You can see like it's going to lock easily at 45 degree angle. So you can lock it when it's done. Then on the side here with this lock here, you control the height of the platter. For this specific machining, you need to put it at the minimum. What we want to avoid is the bit to go through the full side, the full thickness of your panel. As you can see here, the depth of the bit will leave a good millimeter on the other side of the panel. and this is what you want. So I'm going to trace 8 inches both sides. For the N1, I'm going to use the stopper. And for this, I can do both at the same time. I'm going to put my safety goggles and I'm going to start machining. So when you put the glue, sometimes it's very tight, so you can use a little like hammer to push your domino down. Make sure not to knock too hard, because as I showed you earlier, you don't have lots of panel left on the other side. So if you knock too much, you're gonna damage the other surface of your project, and you want to avoid that at any cost. So here's the domino. It's very tight. That's a good assembly. And the other part, putting right here. Et voilà. This is how I use a domino every day in my shop. I use this tool all the time and I love it. I hope you're gonna get yours. My name is David. See you soon.